fourth quarter. Let's see if they can maintain it. A low knuckling kick. Lemon sticks it down the middle of the field. Takes it off with downfield at the 25, 30, 35, 40 up the sideline. Hits knocked out of bounds at the 43-yard line. Lex Jones on the return. Boy, that's a skidded pass that couple of players for Jones able to get the big hop out of it and field it. He returns it up to the 43-yard line. The Gauchos have the people out celebrating. I don't know if it was players, I don't know if it was people along the sideline, but the people out on the field, they get nailed for a 15-yard penalty, so they get the field position, but they're down 22-7 with 9:43 to play. Both teams need a win here to lock up a winning season. The Gauchos 5-4, the Mustangs 4-3-1. Gauchos on top 22-7 in the fourth quarter. It's the option, takes back to Mitchell on the far side, 40, he outruns one man, 45, midfield, 45, down the sideline, out of bounds at the 41-yard line. That is a 17-yard carry, and he goes out of bounds to stop the clock. The Gauchos can't let him move the field that quickly.
And then we've got a Gaucho jersey out there, number 24, who does not stay with the pitch man. But the coaching told us he just came off the field. He's not who he is. But he's got number 42, Gerald Thomas, back in that spot now.
Pick up of 17 yards, first and 10 now. Just inside the 40-yard line. The Mustangs on the move. Man in motion to the far side. Hand it off to him. Inside the 35, running behind a blocker. Looks like a flying leg. Inside the 30, down to the 27-yard line. Amira on the carry. He was in motion to the far side. To the field, puts the hand off. Amira just blowing through the Gaucho defense. That's 12 yards. He carries to 29 yards. And I thought it was good field position because it's a penalty after the celebration on the two-point conversion. Receiver coach. Say, hey, it's a 35-point speed he's got. They have a great offense. They had some good drives early in the game that ended in turnovers. They had four first-half turnovers. They haven't been on the field here in the second half. They're starting to move the ball in these last two plays. Picks back to Mitchell. Keeping it in the inside. He's in trouble. Hands in by Preston. He'll reverse field. Preston is taking it. He's all the way back to midfield. 45-40 with the move. When you get hit with a 15-yard penalty, the Gauchos coach is substitute for you 99% of the time. You might get a break if they think it's a bad call, but most of the time, if you commit a personal foul, you get to sit down and think about it. Kevin King is pleading his case with Mike Warren right now. And Mike Warren's pointing at the line of scrimmage going, look where that thing is now. The King's out of the lineup, and the Gauchos have to follow a 15-yard penalty. They picked up two on the carry. But now it's all the way back to the 22-yard line, and they got to go out to the 44. Actually, they picked up almost three on that carry.
Wide receivers even need to stay in the game. He's one good penalty. He's got one
good. He's almost a tight end. Second and 22 for the Gauchos at their own 22. They're going to draw. They're going to run a draw. Hayner out across the 25 to the 26. They've broken some big draws before, but they don't get one there. Brewster and King check back into the game at wide receiver. And he dealt with a good read, stopping Hayner after a 3-yard gain. It's now third down and 17. But with the clock moving, 8:26 to play in the game, I wouldn't be surprised to see the Gauchos running here on third down and take some more time off that clock. They're up 22-7, and back at their own 25, they don't want to turn it over. Murray the tailback, Hayner the fullback, they're in the eye. Third and about 19 at the 25. There's the handoff. Murray up the middle across the 25 out to the 28. Then Brian Fleming will come in and punt the ball away for the Gauchos. Andy Bell on the stop. 8 minutes exactly to play in the game. Gauchos up 22-7.
And they did have a chance to put Scott Brewster in that game. Looks like he's running around up here, so he's going to get a chance to get a couple of balls. That's a good spot of
Brewster and Wallace have been battling for the receiving title on his team all year. Wallace had a one-catch lead when play started today, but I think he's got three more grabs than Brewster right now, so he's up four for the season. Have to see what happens when the offense goes back in. Right now they're busy running out the clock. Clock ticking down. Fleming taking his time. Now he gets the snap and gets away the kick. It's fielded back to the 35-yard line. And he's down to the far side. In pursuit. Tries to whip behind one man and ends up getting buried at the 34. He got forced to take a deep swing back there by Bill Thomas. He got around Thomas, but he got finished off by Fred Freckin and Lance Neal over there at the 34.
Run all over the field before the fumble. They got some pretty good foot speed on that fumble.
So the Mustangs get it back. 7:13 to go in the game. They need a touchdown drive right here. They trail 22-7. The referees are stopping the clock now. Their time. The teams aren't quite set. They're tangled across the way. Straighten that out. This game brought to you in part by Wendy's, where the world's old fashioned and you get the best quality food at the best price. Wendy's proud to be a UCSC football and basketball supporter. And also by Pacific Beverage Company and Budweiser. For all you do, this best for you. And since it is homecoming, time for us to say hello to alumni from the Bay Area Class of 80. We got that note passed here. A lot of alums on hand today. We haven't heard the crowd announced, but it looks like they got about 6,000 or 7,000 out here today for the homecoming game. We got the biggest crowd of the season. And it'll be the biggest crowd in any outdoor athletic event all year. Coffin takes the snap, drops back the pass. Standing in, he's hit. He lets it go. He throws it out of bounds. This will be the biggest event in the Gaucho. Cochran has a second and 10. He's going to take the snap, roll to the inside. Has a little time, throws, flips it again. It's intercepted. No one there. Hand around the rest of the room. Picks up back into the field, right down the sideline. He puts it out to the 48 and turns it down to the 31. Look at this. An easy pickoff. The receiver started it down and out.
Yeah. safe pass for the Dodgers to be throwing. They got the first down.
And they're dead ball foul.
So they'll have a first down. They'll have four more plays because they can't beat up the clock. But you don't need guys jumping over the top of piles to take contact. Just like you didn't need King Clark.
And what a great target Cade
Caleb Chabot is. John Russell was a big target last year. All those guys about 6'2", 6'3". But when he's trying to find Mitchell downfield at 5'9", and of course he's got the arms you'd expect on a 5'9 guy. So he's tougher.
And now he's back throwing into that skinny size too. Once makes it real tough on those guys.
Any receiver who runs the pattern on the right side of the field is looking back into the sun trying to pick up that ball. Not an easy pass. Second and 10. Mitchell in motion to the far side. They're running the option to the far side. Stockton goes upfield on his own midfield. 45 to the 43. And I can hear the Gauchos coaches kicking the ground and shouting and screaming in the box next to him. 3:59 to play in the game. Quite a ruckus being made next door. My guess is they didn't like the way that play was handled. Some of the fans and the stands coming around looking in the box. You know, they got headphones, but sometimes it's just easier to shout down to the sideline. They're running the option to the far side. Cochran takes it, turns up field down the sideline, knocked out of bounds. Loose ball, but it goes out of bounds. What a break for Cochran.
Well, I think he fumbled for a first down.
Man, his knee is broken out of bounds, and you're right. He fumbled forward for the first down.
I think Cochran ran for about 7, and the ball went the rest of the way out going. Another 3 yards.
And it goes out of bounds. He stops the clock. It's 3:45 to play. Ball at the 33-yard line. First and 10. The Mustangs can punch it in. They might get back to their onside kick. 3:45 to play. Panthers need to drive that final nail in the coffin here. Mitchell in motion to the near side. It's Austin to the near side. Cochran pursued by Cookie. Cookie gets out to Mitchell. He's wrapped up and dropped by Gigi. Blank field. Held it out. He did for a loss. Back to 36. The loss of 2 and the clock moving. And remember, in the third quarter, the Mustangs used back-to-back timeouts on the first possession. One of them to argue with the officials so they can only stop the clock one time the rest of the game.
Great combination play by Fred Cookie.
Second down now and 12. Cochran rolls to the right, looks back, throws long down the middle. Touchdown! A tremendous grab in the end zone. A diving catch by Herman Andrews, and it was right in between the defenders. Goodell covering him one on one, and Nicosia coming over to help out, and the ball slid him right into Andrews' arms as he made the diving touchdown catch. And with 3:02 to go, it's now 22-13. But I expect they will go for two here because the Gauchos went for two on that fake.
That's number 83. We've seen him on a couple of those punt returns, Herman Andrews, and they did exactly what we had to talk about the Gauchos doing. Find a one-on-one coverage. They had their little speedster, number 83, and he ran that post side.
They're going for two now. Cochran takes their snap. Roll, puts it back to Mitchell. He's headed for the corner. He's in. He's in for two. And they're still alive. If the Gauchos had stopped that, they still would have needed two possessions to win the game. Two scores. But now it's 22-15. 3:02 left in the game. Rob Bauer, the running back out there. Lance Neal, a linebacker, also out there. Scott Rooster back at the 10, the only man deep. Here comes the kick. And it's deep. They kicked it away. Unbelievable. Brewster will take it at 9. 10, 15, 20. Cut away from one man. 25. And he's wrestled to the ground. They tried to strip him, but he held on. Well, the Astros get a break there. The Mustangs don't even challenge him. They're going to play for three field position. Figure three downs and out. Let's get the ball back. And now, the Astros offensive line is going to have to blow up and throw. So you see a beat and run out.
Gauchos
got four receivers in the game, but they're going to run it on first down over the right side. Duke Buckner out to the 28. They'll pick up about 3. It'll be 2nd and 7 on the clock. Moving with 2:51 to play. Mike Turner on the tackle for West New Mexico State. Now, the Gauchos have been in games twice where they tried to protect the lead right by running out the clock. At Humboldt State, up 24-21, Mike Warren went through a lot of play action. They moved the ball down the field. They ate up the clock, and they scored a touchdown to Isaac. 2 weeks ago at Azusa Pacific, they tried to just sit on the ball and run it out and get the ball back and let the defense stop Azusa Pacific, and they ended up losing the game, giving up 2 late touchdowns. I wonder if they'll throw it here. They're going to hand off on 3rd down. Ross Bauer on a counter, and he gets for a loss. So now it's 3rd and 8. Clock moving. 2:13 left. If they run the ball, they can get back to the Mustangs with about 1.5 minutes to play. Like I said, at Humboldt, he was throwing on 2nd and 3rd down. They ran a lot of play action, and they moved the ball well. At Azusa, they just tried to run as much time off as they could on 3rd and long. They were running the ball, and they punted away, and the defense never really had much of a chance because the punt got blocked. And the same kind of scenario set up here now. 3rd and
Andrews brought him over the middle. Bruce Kingsinger to the far side. He's looking straight back to pass. They're going to throw. He steps up the pocket. Back it off. Pass it behind the wall. Incomplete or fumble? Incomplete. So it stops the clock. But Gaucho can't execute on third and eight. They're going to have to punt the ball away. And the incompletion stops the clock with 1:34 to play. Here comes the punt by Fleming. He gets it away. He throws it. Fleming throws it out. Fleming has a post. He had running room. Ryan Fleming got the adrenaline going. Perfect. Strong. He's at their own 28. Mitchell in motion to the far side. Five in the snap. Down the line. Turns it up to 30, 35. Inbound. Just inbound. He tackled out of 37. Now they're not going to get it to him. They just moved the court, so they stop the clock. 1 minute left, they're going to move the game through. yards in 3 minutes. And they're going to call timeout. They're going to use the timeout here. The Mustangs call timeout. They play all afternoon. They could have done this at the start of the game.
He did hobble about 5 to 6 yards off the field of play. Staying working on the game.